Hello everyone and welcome back to the walkthrough! Are you ready to take on Ganon? Are you? Well, too bad, because I got other stuff to show here. I like building suspense, so let's get to that. Meanwhile, on the viewer's end...
What is this crap? I'm skipping ahead! This is stupid!
First, over here at the Swamp Palace, apparently I missed the compass, and I did. So it's in the room south of here, I guess? Let's see, I didn't really explore here, did I? So let's go around here and see what I missed. Well, obviously a compass, but but what I mean is, what haven't I really shown here, like walking-wise and whatnot? I believe I just have to push this block and, yep, that's what I thought. Woo! Thank you very much! Alright, here's an easy one. Fly over here, get your hammer, pick this up, and I apparently forgot to look at the cave up there in the Dark World, so let's see what's in here. I'm pretty sure it's a fairy fountain, which is why I didn't check. Oh, it's not. Or maybe it is. Let's see. We'll see. Hey, I'll tell you if I... Okay, sure, why not? There's a tiny circle of rocks in the lake of the source of the river. I don't know what will happen. Might be fun to throw something into it. See you. Oh, that's the one that gave me... the Quake Medallion. Oh, well, that was fun to check out anyway. So apparently, over here... you were right! And thank you very much. So this is a way to switch the worlds over on this side, I guess, to the awkward lava volcano world. Obviously that other portal was an optional thingajigger, but it's good to know that it's there anyway. Now how did this work again? Wasn't it like something... Yeah, something like that. Okay, now back in this room, I forgot about a wall here behind the skulls. Yes, thank you as well. Whoop. So let's see what's behind door number 3. What? Uh-oh. What, really? Is that just detailing then? Huh. So that's not an actual bombable wall. Okay. Now for some enemy traits and names that I didn't really show off. So let's go into the Skull Woods here so I can show you. Get out of my... Stop. Nope. Get... Okay. Now there's this right here, the picket. Yeah, it steals stuff from you, and it can also steal your shield if you don't have the mirror shield, basically. Although I do believe it can steal the mirror shield in the Game Boy Advance version of the game, but ow. But in this one, it'll just steal other things if you have the mirror shield, because it can't steal a mirror shield. So yeah. This not-so-friendly ghost here is Ryu. Yeah, it's the Dark World version of the Poe. Now for this critter, the Octorok imitation known as Slowrock. Finally, back in Thieves Town, you know, the dungeon, pull on this, and yep, these are the skull ropes that I was talking about. Back at the Ice Palace, I've got a little trick to show you here. Remember these stairs? Remember them? Well, I figured out an easier way to get down them. I'm gonna get this out ahead of time for something that I want to show you in the other room, but watch us. Get yourself aligned very carefully with that line in the middle of the stairs, away from the guru bar. When it passes, run down! And that's how it's done. Now, for this here, I was told to kill these guys, and something will appear. It's bombs! Thank you very much! Alright, next trick, start from the sanctuary. I've got a little secret for you. Run. Keep running with the Pegasus boots, trust me on this. It's very important for this. You gotta be as quick as possible. Now, I'm gonna do this trick this particular way, but there's other ways of doing this, but they all lead to the same room. You probably know what room I'm talking about here, but anyway, start up here, place a bomb about there, turn away from it, and then get blasted by it. Now, Pegasus boots down the screen, quickly, go, and I mean quick. I'm not kidding you, go as fast as you possibly can. I'm not sure I'm fast enough. Go. Caffeine, need it. Now, go. Now go down here. Oh, geez, not fast enough. Let's see if I did it. Go. I did it. This is the Chris Houlihan room, and this room is a contest winner's room, I guess you could say. Back in Nintendo Power, you enter the contest and you'd get your name in a secret room. Well, you get to see this secret room if you do something that would otherwise cause the game to crash. Yeah, this room is like a fail-safe room, and if you leave it, you end up back at your house for some reason. What? Alright, after that excursion, I healed myself all up, and now there's two other things to mention here. Yeah, I did know about the bug catching that thing on Aghanim, but I forgot to mention it, I'm sorry. And the other thing was something I didn't know. When you freeze the fire or ice head when using the fire or ice rod on them, you can apparently attack them with your sword. That would have saved me a lot of magic. Alright! Time to go down and take on Ganon! Woo!
Ah! There we go! Finally! I found the spot where he's gonna fight that dang pig!
Oh boy! I never imagined a boy like you could give me so much trouble! It's unbelievable that you defeated my alter ego, Aghanim, the Dark Wizard, twice! So does that mean I technically beat you twice already? I will never give you the Triforce. I will destroy you and make my wish to conquer both light and dark worlds come true without delay. I wish you the best of luck on that, because I am not gonna let that happen as long as I exist. So I'm just gonna attack him a few times here. He's flinging his trident around wherever I am in the last spot. It just kinda sorta homes in on you a little bit, and he's also got this fiery attack. Sometimes, depending on the position, you can get a couple hits in like so, but watch out for the blazing bats here. They are invincible, and they do quite a bit of damage, but come to think of it, he also does quite a bit of damage, even with the, I should actually have, magic cape up, but whatever. I should, always watch my health, even though I've got the power of red on me, you know, quarter damage tunic on, so it's a thing of, he still does a lot of damage even though that you've got some pretty powerful defenses on you. He is truly the strongest boss in the game, let's just put it that way. Oh boy. By the way, I got potions, I still got the same potions that I had from before, and whenever he does that floor shaky thing, that's when he knocks floor tiles off. So yeah, I've just got to watch my health and use the potions when need be. Everything should go okay. You are doing well, lad, but can you break through this secret technique of darkness? Yeah, en garde! Of course I can, I've got the fire rod. And fire beats darkness! Yes, and by doing that, you can stun him with your sword when the light is on, and then switch over to the all-important bow and silver I missed them! That was like point-blank range. Bow and silver arrows, which are required to beat the game. So if you don't have them, you are stuck. And that will not make you happy. So make sure you got the upgrades from Rosie O'Donnell. Oh yeah, you can only shoot them once per cycle. That is all right. All right, let's do that again. Stun him. Yeah, when he goes right through you whenever he does that burr thing. There we go, okay, switch back to the fire rod! We're almost done here, folks! Almost done here! Stun! Aw. I can get this out at least. Take that! Oh! No! Yes! Alright, now I can get this back out for stunning time and combo attack! And now, once again, fire rod, light those torches. Oh, you got in my way! How dare you! How dare you! How could you do this to me? You're humiliating me. And for that, I will kill you. Woo! Yeah! The game is beat. Or is it? Is the game really beat? Is it truly beat? I think it's Beats! Because there's the Triforce! Woo! Welcome, Link. I am the essence of the Triforce. Yes, the Triforce will grant the wishes in the heart and mind of the person who touches it. I think they're kind of recapping what we already know from the game's story. If a person with a good heart touches it, it will make his good wishes come true. If an evil-hearted person touches it, it grants his evil wishes. Like Ganon. But he's gone now. And they said as long as the person lives, the wish will be granted. But he's gone, so... the stronger the wish, the more powerful the Triforce's expression of that wish. So... what is exactly does that mean? Ganon's wish was to conquer the world. That wish changed the Golden Land to the Dark World. So yeah, that's, again, another recap sort of thing. I guess his wish was really strong to transform an entire world. Ganon was building up his power here so he could conquer the Light World and make his wish come completely true. Well, it was temporary, I guess, but it did come true. But now you have totally destroyed Ganon. His dark world will vanish. Woo! Aw, yeah! Does that mean we'd get a wish ourselves? The Triforce is waiting for a new owner. Its golden power is in your hands. Alright, so what should we wish for here? Now, touch it with a wish in your hearts. Alright, so let's touch the Triforce here. Come on, form. Stop turning like a Rubik's Cube, there we go. Alright, I wish for world peace and a rainbow umbrella! And now we get to see the results of the wish. First, the return of the king! Yes! He's back! All is well, and you notice that the guards are also a lot happier looking as well, because they're no longer possessed or about to be possessed by the doom that was the takeover and whatnot. So, yep, people are coming back! People are coming back. It is beautiful. All is well, truly. Except the rainbow umbrella. Yes. So this is where you get the names of the dungeons and stuff like that. Hey, no, those chests are mine, Mr. Lockpicker. Oh, no. Oh, I hate the boss of that place. Oh, there's Ball Guy and Bully Guy. But yeah, that boss gotta go. Absolutely has to go. So the uncle's back. They said recover, so does that mean he never died? Something tells me... no. But he's back now, and all is good, so... that is happy there as well. And of course, Zora's Waterfall. Where would we be without the flippers? We wouldn't be able to go to all sorts of different places. And yep, magic shop. Gots to get your magic before Ganon, to an extent. But especially Dungeon 8 of the Dark World, because that place, that's got a ridiculous amount of magic use. Yes. So, Woodsman Hut. They're cutting another tree. I hope this one's a lot more solid than the one that had a hole in it. I really do. And there's the guy with his kid. Yep. They're doing well as well now. Venus, Queen of Fairies. Not to be confused with a certain fairy over in the Dark World. And yeah, let's not forget about Rosie here. Smithery, I guess that is the place that is called. I mean, that it's called, yep. And now they're bobbing their heads in time with the music. Because music makes the world go round. Bug-catching kid has gotten over his cold. That is excellent. Kuko's having a good time. That is also excellent. Look at that. So happy. Everywhere. Across the world. No more Dark World. Just the Golden Land. And this now recovered mainland. He's not that lost. He knew how to get his way through. Well, I guess maybe he didn't to an extent, because when we got there, we had to kind of escort him. But then after a little while, he knew what he needed to do to get there. Ah, yes, if it was not for your hint, we would not have gotten the fourth bottle. Thank you there, Mr. Thief Guy Man, whatever. And now the Master Sword sleeps again. Forever! Until another Zelda game. So that's not true in the slightest. They lied to us. They lied to us. But I am glad that there are other Zelda games. And now we get to watch Zelda pieces, well, Triforce pieces spin. Spin all day long while the credits play. As usual, I like to say, I did not make the game, these awesome people did. I just made the walkthrough to help and entertain people with every aspect that I could think of in the game. It's a game that you don't want to miss out on, like in all aspects, so that's part of why I made the walkthrough. I like showing off that sort of thing, because I don't like when people miss stuff. It's, yeah. Maybe it's part of my OCD that I want people to enjoy the game to its fullest, just like I do. Well, or at least hope it. You don't really have to get everything, I suppose, if that's how you enjoy games the most, but I feel I get the most out of games by 100%ing them, and that's what I do, at least. So, yep, credits scrolling at an abnormally slow pace. This is rather awkward, I gotta say. I mean, there's not really much to talk about here. Even the Triforce pieces aren't turning around like Rubik's Cube like they were before. This... What am I supposed to do now? I mean, I guess I could watch the clouds move by on the triple parallax scrolling going on there. Actually, it's more like 4 or 5 different layers of scrolling going on there infinitely. Because, yeah, you got the clouds and the green grassy foothills in the foreground, you know, the thickest, whitest clouds at the top and bottom. I mean, the top, then you got the foothills at the very bottom. And you got those other clouds, got 1, 2, 3, yeah, at least 5 layers going on here. Plus the credits layer, plus the Triforce piece layer. It's just craziness. So maybe there is something to talk about here after all. So crazy. I think the police would be called on this party. It's wow. There's just people dancing around all over the place. You can't really see them on top of the foothills there, but they got the crazy spirit of the multi-parallax scrolling going on here. Yes. In all honesty, the credits probably should have been probably plopped along with the whole world tour showing everyone doing all right and whatnot. So yeah, at least that's my opinion. Because otherwise it seems like it's, I don't know, too long, my opinion. Although I suppose you can kick back and relax, or not, because remember the craziness. Yes. The craziness. So, quest history. What is this craziness? What is this? Yeah, it's the deaths, if I'm not mistaken. Yeah, I had some dumb stuff going. It's alright though. We made it through just fine. This is actually a pretty hard Zelda game, so I figured a couple of deaths would happen in my save file would be unpristine, I guess you could say, from being 000 eventually. And I do believe they do count deaths, even if you have a fairy. So yeah, it was technically 22 deaths during this playthrough. Alrighty! Got some nice stats. The end. 22! Yep, they show the number now. There it is. My faithful rainbow umbrella. So I guess that means this walkthrough is concluded. So I hope you enjoyed, and I'll see you- wait, there's actually one more thing I should probably do against my better judgment?
Da-dung, 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 da-dung,
da-dung. Oh my Arceus robot Chicken, sharpie, and where there is a brown ass, please,